So now I would like to talk about your life as Orwellian and as a committed member of the community. Would you like to talk about that?
Yes, of course, because this is my life, no? And as you say, I'm deeply committed to Orville. But it happened that at one point, let's say quite long ago, in 84, I was involved in many activities in Orville. I've been involved in almost everything you can imagine, no? From working in the bakery, running the Orville News, doing architecture, starting an ecological farm, going abroad for fundraising, being part of the different governing boards, whether, I don't know how we call them at that time, the co-op. So I've been all that. Also, I was a big mouth, so I had a lot to say in meetings. But at one point, I got quite impatient with the slow pace of the collective, you see, as if you have always to wait for the others. I have a problem. I'm not very patient, and that's one of my problems. So I was tired of waiting for the others to work. So at one point, I wanted really to work, to be able to work 10 hours a day without waiting for the consensus of a group or the opinion of this or this one. So I knew I was an artist since I am born. When you are an artist, you know, because you see the world differently, you react differently too, and you have experience that people don't have sometimes. So I felt maybe I should, it's time now, I forget everything about it, I just plunge, and I have to find the thing.